Congratulations on your decision.
Thank you very much.
How do you feel?
Well, I feel great because we've been working here in New Hampshire over the last few years and made real progress as a state, expanding middle-class opportunity, making sure we're helping businesses create jobs, moving our economy forward. Unfortunately, we are not getting the response we need from Washington that really meets the progress we've made at home. Washington right now is rigged for special interests who make sure that their needs are met at the expense of the middle class. I think that needs to stop, and that's exactly why I'm running for the United States Senate.
For you personally, was this a tough call?
Well, I love doing what I do as governor. We've made real progress working across party lines to move our economy forward while holding the line against an income or sales tax. What I find as I talk with the people of New Hampshire, whether it's a teacher saying she can't afford to send her daughter to college, or a structural engineer telling me he's worried about the state of our roads and bridges and we need to continue fixing them, we're not getting the response from Washington that will help us continue that progress. So as I listen to the people of New Hampshire, I think it's really important that we stand up to the special interests that are really rigging the system for themselves at the expense of the middle class. And that's what I want to do, is stand up for the people of New Hampshire and the United States Senate.
How much encouragement did you receive throughout the last several months as speculation swirled about your possible candidacy for U.S. Senate?
I've been really just honored and privileged to work as governor and to be out talking with people in our state each and every day. And I've gotten encouragement from people within the state. I've gotten encouragement from people around the country. What's most important to me is that we have a Senate that puts the people of New Hampshire first and the interests of the middle class first, and that's what I want to do in the Senate.
You're a very popular governor. Your job approval ratings are high. As you were going about making this decision, what were the components that you took into consideration? Family, work, the job itself?
You know, when I talk with people in New Hampshire about the progress we've made, the fact that we've been doing things the New Hampshire way, we've reached across party lines, had bipartisan agreements that's balanced two budgets. We've held the line against a sales and an income tax. We're fixing our roads and bridges. We've expanded health care for over 40,000 hardworking Granite Staters. What I hear the people of New Hampshire saying is that they wish we had the New Hampshire way operating in Washington. Right now, Washington is really rigged for the special interests and against the middle class, and that needs to stop. We can make progress in Washington for the people of New Hampshire if we bring the New Hampshire way, that problem-solving, common-sense attitude that is so critical to who we are. If we bring that to Washington, we can move forward, and that's what I want to do.
With all due respect to Ovid Lamontagne and Walt Havenstein, most people expect this to be a major, major political battle against the Republican incumbent, who's popular in her own right. What kind of campaign do you expect and hope to run?
Well, I think it's going to be a vigorous campaign. I'm running for the United States Senate because the people of New Hampshire need us to bring the New Hampshire way to Washington. Right now, we've worked in New Hampshire to expand middle-class opportunity, especially around education. We froze college tuition here for the first time in 25 years and lowered it at our community colleges. We are fixing our roads and bridges. We've expanded health care. We've balanced our budget without an income or sales tax. Unfortunately, Senator Ayotte has stood with special interests. She has voted to cut Pell Grants for college students. She has voted to make Medicare a voucher system and to erode Social Security benefits. And she's voted to defund Planned Parenthood. She has stood with special interests rather than with the people of New Hampshire. I'll put New Hampshire first, and that's what this campaign will be about.
How do you plan on navigating your day job that you still have while running a campaign?
My focus each and every day will be on my job as governor of the state of New Hampshire, a job I love, a job that is just such a privilege because the people of New Hampshire demonstrate how to problem solve each and every day, and they bring their ideas and their suggestions to their elected leaders, and they're incredibly inspiring. So my focus will be on that job in each and every day. Just as I balanced campaign duties when I ran for re-election, I'll be able to do that here.
And you've been asked questions, obviously, throughout the last several months related to New Hampshire, and you've been asked questions related to foreign policy. So I'm going to end this interview with a question that you're probably going to be asked again, just to kind of get your take on things. The Iran nuclear deal, obviously there's a lot of different opinions on that. From what you've been able to gather, where do you stand?
Well, government's first job is to keep its citizens safe and to protect America's security. like Senator Shaheen, like national security experts and foreign policy experts from both political parties, I've concluded that this imperfect agreement is the best available option to prevent Iran from having a nuclear weapon. But it is really important that it is only a first step. We have to make sure that we preserve and enhance Israel's military superiority. We have to work with our allies across the world to keep the pressure on Iran so that they will comply with the deal. We have to improve and strengthen our intelligence resources so that we have real-time information about whether they're complying with the deal. What's really important for people to know is that as long as I have anything to do with it, Iran will never have a nuclear weapon. That's one of the reasons I'm running for United States Senate.